In the 2002 Brazilian film City of God, the narrator, translated in English as Rocket, tells the tale of the City of God, a slum in Brazil. Young men, faced with dire poverty, commit small robberies to put food on their tables and keep their heads above water. One of them grows up to be called Little Z, a drug lord. The drug trade in the City of God is contested between rival factions and monitored by a corrupt police force. The tagline of the film is, "If you run, the beast catches you. If you stay, the beast eats you." A proverb similar to the English, "Damned if you do, damned if you don't." This references an early scene in which the narrator is trapped between being shot by the police or shot by the gang. In the City of God, in extreme poverty, you can either be condemned by the police by committing crimes to better your life, or you can be condemned by the gangs for distancing yourself from them or working against them. In extreme poverty, your options are limited. There is always a lack, a privation. There are a great many causes of crime, and labeling only one does not take into account the various crimes having different causes, but in terms of crimes seen in City of God, meaning participation in the drug trade and the violence that sometimes comes with it, as well as small-time robberies, one notable contributing factor is poverty. If you don't have enough to pay the bills, you need more. If you can't get a better job, or jobs are unavailable to you for some reason, then you do what you feel you need to do. Those born into poverty generally do not have the choices that people not born into poverty have, and this contributes to hopelessness, and the lack of options can lead to narrowing down to just one option: crime. These are universal truths, as studies in different countries yield similar results. Starting from the 1970s, studies in the United States pointed more and more to a link between unemployment, poverty, and crime. This is not regional, it occurs everywhere, including Brazil. Not having, but needing, is universal. Research from the UK even indicates that economic cycles may affect variations in poverty and violent crime. The United Nations and the World Bank both rank crime high on the list of obstacles to a country's development. According to the Oxford Handbook on the Social Science of Poverty, evidence for a positive association between individual or family poverty and criminal offending is generally strong. A review of 273 studies assessing the association between different dimensions of social and economic status and offending concludes that there is consistent evidence from multiple national settings that individuals with low income, occupational status, and education have higher rates of criminal offending. There are other factors, of course, but many are related. Quality of education is a factor, yes, but it relates to poverty because the poor are less likely to afford an education outside of the public school system, or access to expensive university-level education at all. Even community college is not a free ride. Funding to public schools is not what it could be, and funding in the inner cities is often worse than average. In City of God, we see few references to education. Towards the end of the film, the Runts, a child gang, talk amongst themselves and ask each other who knows how to read. Their illiteracy tells us a lot about how their lives became what they are. In the film, the City of God is home to the homeless. After terrible flooding, displaced people were moved to this slum. The narrator says that the rich do not care, and the slum is not provided with enough electricity, paved roads, or the basics of human life. Now, schools don't just teach you algebra and Brazilian civics, they teach you how to live in a society. They are socializing factors in our lives. Due to the condition of schools in poor urban areas, many students do not attend regularly. Are they learning any social skills while being systemically discriminated against? Why would the children in the City of God trust any form of authority when the police call them racial slurs, shoot them when they are unarmed or from behind, and debate robbing their corpses? Another study across 20 cities analyzed how local inequalities and heterogeneous populations can influence crime rates. Inequality is a major cause of crime. Research dating back to 1966 with the famous Coleman Report shows that proper integration into society is key to better grades and successful education. And if successful education reduces the chances of crime and said integration is not happening, crime increases. The young people in City of God rarely, if ever, consider a life outside of crime. With so few options and crime being the most viable, it is also the most tempting. Poverty is generational. It can be escaped, of course, but often if one's parents are poor, they cannot provide enough for your success, which continues the cycle. The young people in the City of God see their parents' lives and do not see hope. Why would anyone follow the legal path if they see that their parents did so and are still jobless or at least exploited? If your identity and your place in society are constantly questioned, often by the government itself, it is not motivating to work within a flawed system. Another thing, and this is rather uncomfortable, but it needs to be said, Brazil was the last country in the Western world to abolish slavery. By the time it was abolished, an estimated 4 million slaves had been imported from Africa to Brazil. It was abolished, yes, but freed slaves start from nothing. Generational wealth of their children is limited, whereas generational wealth among families whose parents or ancestors were not slaves is greater and more abundant. Slavery was obviously not exclusive to Brazil, and the effects of slavery as it relates to poverty can be seen elsewhere in the world, even in my own country. Lil Z, the closest the film has to an antagonist, is probably the descendant of an African-born slave. Skin color was a significant factor in determining the status of freed slaves. Lighter-skinned slaves had higher chances of social mobility if they were granted freedom. Based on these factors, as well as geographical location and poverty, Lil Z probably had few choices in his life except for crime. That does not excuse his actions, of course, but it does explain them. In one scene, one character says, "You think you can make money working?" Brazil is in a unique demographic situation in which a combination of those of African ancestry and people of mixed race are no longer a minority in the country, but due to many factors such as a lack of generational wealth due to slavery, they still face economic hardships. It is remarkably more complicated than that, as Brazilian classification of race is different than in America, but there are links in the description for further reading. Late in the film, Rocket is admired for his photography by the newspaper staff. They are surprised that he was able to get pictures because the City of God is so violent and dangerous. The journalists are too afraid to go there. This fear to enter areas of extreme poverty breed misconceptions from those for whom this is not their lived experience. Politicians sometimes make the erroneous claim that the connection between crime and poverty is backwards. Crime does not cause poverty. Crime is actually a symptom of poverty. Claiming otherwise perpetuates false information that has plagued policy, public perception, and social attitudes that make it next to impossible to effect real change. It contributes to a myth that has plagued the poor, that their situation is exclusively their own fault. If I can leave City of God for a moment and use the city of my birth as an example, Baltimore census data shows that the poverty rate is 24%. Of those in poverty, only 6% will ever escape it in their lifetime, for all of the reasons explained before. So, yes, it is certainly possible to escape poverty, and history is filled with examples, but the statistics do not lie. It is more likely that those born into extreme poverty will remain that way because those who were not got a head start, and being born into such poverty also carries the possibility of turning to crime to survive. When you need to pay rent or feed your family, the poor turn to crime, and that often means selling drugs. Going back to City of God, that is what we see. There are few opportunities except for drugs. The film is a war among various factions for control of the drug trade. This illegal industry fuels violence in the streets. For those who are not shot and killed by the Brazilian police, they are sent to jail. earning a good legal job after serving a criminal sentence compounds the problem of lack of opportunities, creating recidivism. Roman Emperor Marcus Aurelius once said, "Poverty is the mother of crime." He said this almost 2,000 years ago, and it's still relevant today. Hi everyone, if you like what I do, please click on the orange Patreon link below. That's how this show happens. It's also the only way to request an episode. Also, please like, share, subscribe, and click on the notification bell so that you never miss an episode. I'll see you next week.